Well, I feel that, you know, obviously this is a handicap, and obviously we do need to make some kind of an impact in order to save lives. Why these patients are dying is probably the question that we really do need to answer. My own feeling is that a lot of these are arrhythmogenic deaths rather than further thrombosis, if you will, secondary to the thrombosis. So obviously there have already been some impact placed on this by changing the way paramedics, for example, are responding to patients with acute myocardial infarction. So we have made some kind of a dent into this population by allowing our paramedics and the people who are at the scene of a heart attack before the patient actually makes it to the hospital that are able to deliver very good care. The other area is that they're at a lot of the public facilities, there is availability to defibrillators, which I think is extremely important. And certainly having been on an airplane when a patient did have a heart attack and I did not have access to medical therapy, I have been frustrated for that. And I think that in every public facility, gymnasiums, gyms, etc., a state-of-the-art emergency medical kit should be available, and so that we could address these problems.